Friday, June 4th. So the moon is going to be in Aries all day. It is making 8 different aspects as well. I am going to say that we are going to be a little bit restless with this energy. The moon in Aries wants so desperately for change to take place, for new exciting adventures to unfold, for us to boss up in ways and just take charge of life and go after new passions and go after new desires. But again, we're not in the right energy to do that. So the moon makes an aspect with Pluto, and Pluto's like, hey, like, you need to slow down a bit. Yes, I know you're anxious. Yes, I know that you're excited to jump into new things, but we still haven't resolved some of the issues of the past. And if you continue to blaze that path forward without, you know, rectifying some of the situations in your past, you're going to repeat these same life lessons. And we don't want to do that. We want to end these particular chapters so that you can move forward freely, creating new karma, creating new energy. And the moon goes ahead and sextiles the true node, which really pumps the moon up because the moon wants to look forward, right? There's so many aspects making us look back that we just want to move forward, and it can be frustrating and it can trigger a lot of emotions within us. And that conversation with the true node is so exciting for the moon. The moon wants to be brave. He wants to cut cords. He wants to move ahead. He wants new desires. He wants to take the leadership role. He wants new experiences. And then he has a conversation with Mercury, and Mercury's like, dude, we can't move forward right now. We are having to look back. I'm retrograde. We have to look back to this time last year. Remember the relationship drama? Remember the divide that you had, the choices that you made that didn't pan out very well? Think about what it is that you've done in the past and clear that up. Make the connection before it is that you go ahead moving forward. And again, that is going to frustrate the hell out of the moon in Aries, because moon in Aries doesn't want to look back. We just want to move forward. Amplifying this energy, Mars makes an aspect with Jupiter. Mars rules over Aryan energy. Mars, again, very frustrated, very passive aggressive, sitting in Cancer energy, is pretty much done, you know, sticking to the home, sticking to what is old, sticking to what is comfortable, very tired of being on edge, of just waiting for more, you know, shit to hit the fan and drama to unfold, doesn't really want to even do this whole testing boundaries, recreating boundaries thing. And Mars making this aspect with Jupiter is going to turn the volume all the way up and magnify these emotional triggers that are going to be hypersensitive here today. The moon actually conjuncts Chiron, sitting next to Chiron, the wounded healer planetoid in the sky, in Aries energy, illuminating for us our wounds, especially where our ego and identity is concerned. Now, we have a lot of emotion stirring here today, if you haven't picked up on that already. And again, likely we'll be tapping into the shadow parts of the Aryan energy, which is anger and frustration and just tantrums. The moon conjunct Chiron, having this conversation about why we can't move forward and why I'm so attached to certain people, certain ideas, why I can't seem to resolve trauma from the past, why can't we just sweep it under the rug and just move forward and just deal with whatever comes our way. And then the moon has a conversation with Uranus and Saturn once again. If you'll notice, Uranus and Saturn are becoming very much on the stage of illumination again as we build towards their second bout, their second fight, their second conversation of the year on the 14th. And of course, the moon in Aries having this aspect with these two are frustrating this Aryan energy even further, triggering our emotions even further, because this Uranian energy fires the moon up, saying, come on, rebel, let's fight, let's free ourselves, let's move on, let's think about the future. And then Saturn, again, in a retrograde, saying, okay, whoa, you're moving way too fast here. You can't fire up your emotions this way. You can't not acknowledge you know, the life lessons that I'm trying to teach you here. Saturn very much wants us to prove that we've learned the lessons, the hardships, the challenges, the obstacles that we've already been faced with. But of course, the moon in Aries doesn't have any time for this. It just wants to jump into experience. You know, the Aryan energy acts first and thinks later, which is a problem. That's why Aryan people get themselves into situations that A, are dramatic, B, cause them trouble, C, put them in situations to cause silly accidents, and D, burn themselves out before they ever see the finish line. And this is very much the energy of the day. The moon goes ahead and sextiles the sun and makes an aspect with Jupiter, which is just kind of like the conversation continues, like, whoa, stop yourself. Stand in this present moment. Think about what you're doing, right? The moon in Aries doesn't want to think. And the sun in Gemini wants to do anything and everything to do with thinking, to expanding the mind, to expanding the perspective, to thinking about every single detail and how it has played a part in the current circumstances in which we're currently living. Of course, that Jupiter energy just wants to blow things up, make things way bigger than they need to be, more dramatic than they need to be, more intense than they need to be. And of course, that is going to be our downfall if we let that energy intensify us to the point where our anger and frustration from being in the present moment and not being able to move forward as quick and as fast as we would like push us over the edge to have an Aryan tantrum where we go from 0 to 60 and then back again like nothing happened.